I am going to talk about true weight, apparent weight, and weightlessness. Let's say I am holding a physics book on my hand stationary. In this case, force of gravity on the book. In other words, weight of the book equal Fg equal mass times gravity. Mass is in kilogram. G is gravitational field strength, 9.8 Newton per kilogram down. This is the force applied by my hand. Basically applied force. So this is equal to normal force. Normal force exerted by my hand on the book. Okay. Since the book and my hand is stationary, in this case, magnitude of gravitational force equal magnitude of normal force. So they have same magnitude but different direction. If also my hand moves with a constant velocity, it means without acceleration up or down, in this case also this is valid. F magnitude of Fg equal magnitude of Fn. In case my hand move with varying velocities up or down, increasing or decreasing, in this case velocity is not constant and there is acceleration is not zero, there is acceleration. In this case magnitude of Fg not equal magnitude of Fn. I am going to talk about different cases of my hand move. Okay, I hold my physics book again, but this time I accelerate upward like this. Previously, book did not move, stationary, my hand and book did not move. Because of this, net force on the book was zero. Also, if the velocity of my hand is constant up or down, in this case also, net force acting on the book will be zero. But this time I accelerate the book upward. So net force is not zero. Because net force will be mass times acceleration. Okay. Let's say the acceleration is 2 meter second square up. So mass of the book 1.5 kilogram. So in this case F net will be okay 1.5 kilogram. So let's assume up is positive. We can accept negative also. Doesn't matter. Okay. So we accept up is positive. So 2 is positive meter second square. So when I multiply these two numbers, I will get 3 Newton. Because this is positive, so it will be up. So net force will be 3 Newton up. So net force, if I draw free body diagram, so there will be two forces. Force of gravity on the book pointing down and normal forces. Basically the force I exert by my hand. Okay, so what is the net force? Description is net force vector sums of all forces acting on an object. So in this case, acting on the book, there are two forces. So when we do vector sum, Fg plus F normal. So if I isolate F normal will be equal F net minus Fg. Fg. Okay. So I calculated F net already. This is 3 Newton up, so up is positive. So 3 Newton minus Fg is okay. I didn't calculate Fg. Okay, let me calculate Fg. Fg will be m times g. M is 1.5 kilogram. So g is, because gravitational field strength points down, minus 9.8 Newton per kilogram. So Fg will be equal negative 14.7 Newton, or 14.7 Newton down. Okay, so if I substitute this number here, Fg, okay, Fg here, so 14.7 Newton. So when I do this calculation, F normal, I get 17.7 Newton, because positive up. So basically F normal, magnitude of F normal greater than magnitude of Fg. So I need to make Fn a little bit longer. Okay. So why F normal is greater than Fg? Because previously I hold the book, but this time I pushed. So I should apply extra force to create an acceleration. If I move without acceleration, no problem. We get still magnitude of Fg will be magnitude of Fn. But in this case, Fn, magnitude of Fn greater than magnitude of Fg. Okay. So magnitude, so Fn, Fg will be true weight of the book. This is the true weight of the book. As long as location does not change, true weight of the book does not change. I mean, on the surface of the Earth, approximately 9.8. Some places maybe 9.9 or 9.7, but basically around 9.8. So actual weight, this does not change as long as same location. But F normal is the apparent weight of the book. Apparent weight of the book. Apparent weight of the book changes. If I increase the acceleration, if I apply more acceleration, apparent weight even gets more. If I apply less acceleration, apparent weight will be less than, but still greater than Fg. But if I keep it stationary or constant velocity up or down, apparent weight will be equal Fg. So if I apply extremely big, too much acceleration, apparent weight increase so much I can even injure my hand. We can get the formula for apparent weight. So apparent weight F normal equal F net minus F G. Okay, so F net is M times A. So again F normal equal M times A, and F G equal M times G. M times G. So if we factor this, factor M out, A minus G. Okay, I put arrow here. So this is the formula for apparent weight. Okay, we don't have enough time to complete these topics. So I will continue apparent weight and weightlessness in the second video. Thanks.